قلت حيلتي أنت وسيلتي، أدركني يا رسول الله، أدركني يا رسول الله.
It is mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born in the year of the elephant, عام الفيل. In this year, one of the kings of Yemen, Abraha, this was one of the kings of Yemen, he was a Christian, and he felt grieved that the people used to make pilgrimage to Al-Makkah al-Mukarramah. So he built inside Yemen, in Sana'a, the capital of Yemen, a cathedral in which he proposed to challenge the pilgrimage which used to occur at the Kaaba. It just so happened that certain people from amongst the Meccans were aggrieved by this, and therefore some of them defiled that cathedral. In his anger, he wanted to go out and destroy the Kaaba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He led an army with its elephants in order to go and destroy the Kaaba of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. This was 55 days before the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to the ulama of Seerah, according to the ulama of the books of Seerah. So this was before the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he made it his intention that because an individual had defiled the cathedral, that he felt it was up to him now to take revenge, and the revenge he sought was the destruction of the Kaaba. It is mentioned that when Abraha approached Makkah al-Mukarramah, the grandfather of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdul Muttalib, came out to meet him and to ask him to return back from what he intended to do. Now, Abraha was set upon this, the destruction of the Kaaba. And he had led his army, which included, like I mentioned, elephants, and his aim was to take apart the Kaaba. When the grandfather of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdul Muttalib, realized that there was no way of preventing this man from carrying out what he wanted, then he said to Abraha that every house or every construction has someone who takes care of it. And verily there is someone who takes care of this house, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I warn you, and he warned him, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be taking care of the Kaaba, Baytullah, the house of Allah. And he had reliance in that. Reliance on the fact that the Kaaba did not need any protection, because the Kaaba itself would be protected by the custodian of the Kaaba, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had taken it upon himself to protect the Kaaba. It is mentioned that when Abraha then tried to go forward in order to attack the Kaaba, his elephant reached a point where it refused to go forward. This was an indication that this elephant was under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time it was moved in the direction of the Kaaba, it would come to a standstill. When it was moved in a direction other than the direction of the Kaaba, it would move. When it was placed in the direction of Yemen, it would begin to move. Placed in the direction of the Kaaba, it would refuse to move. An indication, sign from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about his hifz, his protection of that which he holds dear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then, as mentioned in the Quran, sent against the army of Abraha sparrows or birds carrying stones of baked clay. It is mentioned in the Quran, فعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ألم ترى كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيده في تعديل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. صدق الله العلي العظيم. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent birds carrying stones, and these birds rained their stones upon the army of Abraha. These stones burned through the army of Abraha, burned through the elephants which he had brought inside his army. And there was a complete destruction of that army which had been sent to destroy the Kaaba. This was a sign from the signs of Allah before the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by 55 days, according to the ulama of Seerah.